And those are the starting lineups. So kick back, get your popcorn ready. We'll be back in just a moment. Welcome, everyone. Here it is at long last. It's the start of the NBA regular season. I know everyone's just as excited as we are here on 2K Sports to get things underway. Hi, folks. Brian Anderson here, alongside two fantastic analysts, Grant Hill and Brent Berry at the table, and our reporter, Allie LaForce. Hey, Allie.
Thanks, Brian. Well, current financial challenges have Commissioner Silver and the league office dusting off proposals for expansion. Silver said at some point, it's manifest destiny that the league will eventually expand. The last time that happened was 1988 with the Bobcats. Guys, Seattle fans hopeful things move along.
Boy, Allie, wouldn't that be something? And a moment to check out who the Boston Celtics have coming up. On Friday, they'll head home to take on the Toronto Raptors. And then Sunday, they'll face off against John Wall and the Houston Rockets. And the starting group for the Celtics. Smart and Brown, a great defensive backcourt. Robert Williams out there with Al Horford. And it's Tatum in at the three slot. And for New York, Fournier the two, Barrett at the small forward. Inside, we have Randall and Robinson. And it's Burks in at the one spot. And with opening night, Brent, we'll get to see these players going full force.
This is huge. The difference between the preseason and then ratcheting things up for an opening night. The butterflies are there. The excitement is there. The uniform smells better. The lights are a little...
That is what I'm talking about.
Oh, wow. I almost can't believe what I saw. Incredible.
I'm speechless, man. I'm speechless. Robinson, a screen on Brown. Robinson passes to Fournier. For three, Barrett. And out of bounds, Boston will have it.
A sloppy turnover. When you're not locked in, you pay the price.
Brown passes to Horford. Outside, Brown. From outside the arc, knocks down the triple.
Easy look when the defender isn't fighting over the screen.
And the coach over there just asking for one simple thing, and that's some effort. Got burned on that one.
Barrett against Tatum. Launches a three, and it's Barrett with the three.
And Barrett had some time to focus there. He made that one count.
Celtics lead.
Burks against Smart. Horford outside. Back to Smart. Outside Tatum. Six to shoot. Goes up from the top of the key. Robinson with the block.
Hard to score when Robinson's down there being a factor.
Smart.
Hey, when he's hitting that shot, it really helps the spacing for this team.
Yeah, no question. When he is connecting from those kind of spots on the floor, it is just a huge boost for what they can do offensively.
And Burks gets it to go.
Oh, you gotta love the back and forth. Showing real confidence at the arc.
Yeah, both teams finding ways to the three-point line and trying to take advantage from distance.
And setting the tempo with an assertive move. Like, where was the defense on that play?
Yeah, APB sent out to try to find out where the defense is. Inexcusable.
And he's really silencing all the haters. Randall has become a guy you can run the offense through time and time again.
Here's Horford. The Knicks with the rebound.
I think he rushed that one just a little bit, thinking the defense was going to get close. They weren't.
Oh, got that one up quick. Barrett's got 6 points.
Starting to find his rhythm. He's cooking, and he knows it.
Yeah, right now, I don't see any let-up. I think he's going to just keep putting his foot on that gas pedal tonight.
Here's Williams. He's in his comfort zone. 2 for 2 to start this one. And Randle effectively became a point center starting last year.
And coach put him in spots where he can make easy reads. So Randle knows exactly when to attack and when to look for a teammate.
That ties the game.
How about that? The big man, Mitchell Robinson, able to find a teammate.
And Boston calls time here. So New York going with almost an entire new group here. Noel, he's checked in for Robinson. Toppin comes in for Julius Randle. Rose has checked in for Fournier. And quickly subbed in for Burks.
All right, fans.
First quarter of play, and we're about 3 minutes in. And it's stolen by Rose.
2 minutes remaining in the first. 2 minutes.
Pass to Toppin. Back to quickly. The three ball. And again, New York with the triple.
Pretty fundamental play there from Obi Toppin, sending it to the wide open shooter.
Boston has gone 2 for 2 from deep to start this one.
12.
Here's Pritchard. So it'll be 2 free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting.
That's his first personal.
A quick break, and we look at our 2K leaderboard for three-point shooting last season. In third, New York.
Everything clicked for them last year, especially on the perimeter, and they shot a very high percentage. A lot of that due to their offensive schemes. Well, when he gets into a groove at the free throw line, it doesn't just last for tonight. This might be 2 weeks, 2 months, something like that.
Rose up top. He's guarded by White. Quickly from outside. He drops it from range. Quickly's got 6.
A dozen consecutive points off of threes. This defense looks rattled.
18. 14.
Here's Pritchard. And it's blocked by Noel.
And Noel in there to intimidate and does so there.
Here's Barrett. And he drops it in from the low post. Barrett's got his 3rd bucket of the night.
Well, he's knocking down most everything, guys. 3 of 4 here.
Williams, a screen on quickly. Left block shot on the way. And it's Williams with the bucket inside.
And they keep trading punches. Both teams in a groove early.
Who's going to miss first? Every time one team scores, the other team right back at you.
And it's in there.
And their offense looking like a well-oiled machine.
Boston trailing.
Knicks lead, 22-16.
35 seconds left in the first quarter. Back to Pritchard. And there's the drive. And it's blocked by Noel. And it's going to be out of bounds. Boston will have another go. And we've got to see that sensational mobile one block again.
And that kind of rejection early on energizes your squad. The coaching staff just loves this kind of hustle.
Gibson's checked in for Noel.
Josh Gibson.
Pass to Nesmith. Now here's Tice. Just 5 to shoot. Here's White. And a nice finish on the layup.
And their offensive game plan is clear. Get it inside and go to work.
Quickly outside. Screen by Gibson. And the Knicks, another 3.
Such a critical part of how their offense is going to flow. Things are only working when he seems to be on the floor.
Outside, Williams. There's Nesmith with a 3. And again! Boston with the triple.
And both teams running long-range plays that are working.
Well, both of them looking towards the three-point line. And I like to see that, especially when the results are made buckets.
A big-time effort for Emmanuel Quickly, providing a lot of energy for the Knicks. He made a big impact, scoring 12 points in the quarter. And more NBA action on 2K Sports. And the 25th pick in 2020, Emmanuel Quickly.
I feel like I was adopted at a young age. I wasn't always the most athletic, so having skill was really important. So just having that floater that I could, you know, use over a big man is really vital.
Well, Grant, those silky floaters don't always make the highlight reels, but my goodness, are they impressive.
NBA, for a lot of players, that's a bad shot, but it's what he's worked at and perfected over time.
hope you've enjoyed the broadcast so far, halfway through the first half of this one. All right, guys, some stats here. The scoring breakdown for the Knicks.
They definitely had a hot hand from three-point range to this point. Always nice to start out like that.
I'm loving the ping-pong action of the ball tonight. A decent number of assists so far.
On the floor for Boston. At the two and the three, Brown and Tatum. Al Horford out there with Robert Williams. And it's Smart in at the point guard position. The Knicks making a switch here. Robinson's checked in.
Mitchell Robinson.
Foul called on Emmanuel quickly. That'll be a second foul of the game.
This is one where the second foul is probably going to cost you some minutes in this game.
Free throw line jumper. Well, we've had our fair share of father-son duos in the league. For Brent, you and your dad, one of only four duos to win a championship ring each.
Well, I know I was fortunate to win two and not just one, but my dad was really responsible for the one in Golden State in 1975, being the MVP of that final series.
A chance here to catch up with Ali from the sideline.
VA, the Boston Celtics last year had the team's worst win percentage in the last six seasons. The front office admitted, as constituted, they were not a championship caliber team. Now, for this proud franchise, accustomed to competing deep into the playoffs, the question becomes, how do they get back on top?
Yeah, that's a big one. Good stuff there, Alan. Thanks.
Now, the man was wide open there, and Julius Randle understood the timing to get him the ball to get that score.
Brown drives in, shoots over Burks, and that one's long. New York has gone 2 of 3 from the three-point line in the second. Quickly from outside, counted from distance. Quickly's got 20.
They're getting torched on the perimeter. Four of the last five buckets have been threes.
And one big difference for Randle now, his ability to finish with the right hand.
Well, it's opened up a whole world of possibilities as teams just want him to go left. If he spins back and feels confident, he'll use that right hand to get a finish.
And just executing at a high level. I mean, taking what the defense allows and putting in the work.
Basketball IQ is something that gets talked about, but its importance to a team showing up here, running plays and turning the scores.
Well, he's checked in for New York. And a quick pause here. Let's go to the 2K leaderboard and check out last season's best shot blockers. Second, Nerlens Noel.
It's obvious that he completely dedicated himself to protecting the rim, doing everything he could to get his hands on as many shots as possible.
To halt the run, and it's Williams off the drive. And Williams punches it home.
Really as good as any passing big that we have in the NBA. Horford is a guy who can run an offense as a big.
Quickly passes to Burks. And the Knicks, another three.
They've been the more poised team tonight, and the score reflects that.
Yeah, just really pouring it on right now, trying to take away the opposition's motivation to keep competing in this one.
Williams is screened on quickly. Smart passes to Brown. Clock at six. There's the drive. And the jam by Brown.
A strong finish to cut into that lead a little.
Man, left no doubt with that one, Grant.
2 minutes remaining in the first half.
Smart over to help. And the ball is tied up, so we'll have a jump ball.
Quickly. That's his second personal. First team foul.
Right side, Burks. Quickly, left side. Puts up a three. Hauled in by Brown. Boston's gone 1 of 2 from downtown here in the second. Smart passes to Williams. Oh, and makes it with the kiss. Williams has got 8.
Credit their discipline. They've been working for high percentage shots.
Releases. And it's quickly with a miss.
Oh, can't punish the defense for leaving him open that time. That's a frustrating miss for a really steady jump shooter.
Celtics foul. Jason Tatum. That's his first personal. First team foul.
And the first one at the line is good.
Super impressive stuff from quickly in the first year playing in the NBA, just getting up to speed. That didn't seem to be much of a problem.
We got a line change here for Boston. Boston has gone 4 of 5 from outside the arc in this one. 1:14 left in the first half. Down low. The kick out to Williams. Drills it from deep. He's got 5.
Got to try to scramble the Jets right here and get that guy off the sweet spot. That's one of the best 3-point shooters in the league.
Onto the court. Come on and get fouled for your next city dancer.
Almost an entire new group here. New York has gone 4 of 6 from outside, looking sharp here in the second. You know, watching quickly, many of the moves he flashed in college transferred well to the NBA.
And the one thing that stuck out, and a lot of people were talking about, was last year, Emmanuel's ability to hit that floater on the move.
35.
Here's Pritchard. Parries it from about 10 feet away.
Great execution. Could not have asked for a better shot.
It inside, working on Williams. Boston has gone 5 of 6 from three-point land so far.
That's his first personal, second team foul.
Seconds left in the first half of this one. To the paint. Here's Tice.
Robinson so disruptive right now on the inside and contesting everything.
Pure from three-point range.
They're really fighting a losing battle on the glass.
Here's Fournier. Releases from the wing and drills it. Fournier's got 5. Boston has gone 3 of 4 from outside so far in the second quarter. There's Tice with a 3. It's rebounded by Barrett. Four, three, and again, New York with the triple.
Just incredible. I mean, he's really making it rain out there, knocking them down one after another.
Kind of like he's in his living room right now. He's found the comfort zone. Once he gets that, the defense knows they're in trouble.
And so it's New York, a sizable lead of 14 at the break. Off to run with them. They get the ball up the court so fast. Well, now a minute to check in with Allie LaForce. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
Thanks so much. I'm here with Coach Tom Thibodeau. And Tom, what's it going to take down the stretch to win this ball game?
I think just tough defense, take good shots, not turn the ball over, play smart.
Back to the basics. Thanks, Coach.
All right, Allie, thanks for that. We will see everyone right back after this break, ready for the second half.
Welcome. First up, let's look at the two guys who are each leading their respective teams through the first half. And to see these two shouldering the burden, carrying their teams, almost makes your back sore, huh, Shaq?
No, stop it.
Might have to get him some of that Icy Hot. Man up.
You might just... couldn't hurt. And time now to acknowledge what was a tremendous half of play for the Knicks.
Watching that half, they did a great job in transition. It's so hard to score in the half court when you let your defense set up. So anytime you get a chance, go. You go. Kind of reminds me of me in the day. That's why they call me the Jet. Jack, get down the court fast as you can. Come on, man.
That's it for halftime. Thank you for joining us. We send you back to Brian Anderson for the start of the third quarter.
Yeah, there wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. Emmanuel quickly with a strong contribution so far in this one.
And the bulk of his production has been generated along the perimeter.
Yeah, he keeps tracking down those spots behind the three-point line and finding some open opportunities.
Barrett plays the small forward with Randall in at the 4. Emmanuel quickly is out there with Evan Fournier. And it's Robinson into the five down low. That's the five for New York right now. Brown passes to Smart. Inside. Here's Williams. The kick to Tatum. Second chance effort. And that's 2 points Tatum. On the layup.
The assist.
Tatum's gotten his second
Robert
bucket
Williams.
Of the game.
Looks like we're starting to see a pattern here. Not afraid to get in the paint and get wet.
Quickly finds Barrett. And a miss there on the triple.
One thing they've done well tonight, and that's rebounding.
Last year for R.J. Barrett, B.A., now the game is already starting to slow down for him. He's not the reason that they're trailing in this one. He's been on his game. It's a few of the other guys that need to pick it up.
On the wing quickly, defended by Smart. Quickly against Smart. And the Knicks miss again. And Barrett flashing potential as a stopper, Brent.
That's a great sign. I mean, he could be out there on the floor, and you can take confidence in the fact that on nights, if he doesn't have it going offensively, he'll still dig in on deep.
And Brown, the bucket on the assist from Smart.
Assisted by
Smart has got four assists now tonight.
And force feeding the ball inside. I mean, no reason to go away from what's working.
Quickly from outside. Good. He's been great in this one. 9 for 15 after that shot.
Well, him dominating the offensive end is what accounts for this lead. Just a very difficult guy to stop once he gets going.
46.
Smart passes to Tatum. Three-pointer. Fournier with a rebound. The Knicks have gotten just 1 of 5 shots to drop since halftime. Quickly from outside. And again, New York with the triple.
The scoring is coming easy for him. Gotta keep the ball in his hands.
And the Celtics call time here. Emmanuel quickly with a strong contribution so far in this one.
With the way he's cooking, they have to find a way to run him off his spot.
For the Knicks, Gibson's checked in for Robinson. Burks comes in for Fournier. And Rose is subbed in for quickly. Outside, Brown takes a 13-footer. Good on the jump shot. Brown's got 6 in the quarter.
He's really carrying the load, but no man can do it all by himself.
Here's Barrett. Williams grabs the board. Williams has got 6 rebounds now in the game. Pass to Tatum over Randle, and he can't bank that one in.
Yeah, just hasn't been able to find his rhythm offensively, and that's having a ripple effect.
Horford against Burks. The 3, Barrett. And the Knicks, another 3.
Their strategy has been pretty simple here in the second half. Attack from 3-point range.
Maybe trying to find a little bit more space and ball movement to get guys open at the 3-point
range. 2 minutes remaining in the third. 2 minutes.
From the arc. And that one's good. Burks for 3. Burks has got 9.
When you let a team knock down that many 3s, you know you're likely to be on the wrong side of a run.
66.
Smart passes to Brown. There's the triple. He gets it. He's 7 for 8 and really going at him out there.
Yeah, you would think a coach might have talked to his defense about making the adjustment on him, but right now, he's just lighting him up.
Left side, Tatum. Oh, Tatum slams it home.
Give Tatum credit. Getting ideal positioning inside and hammering it down with power.
Well, if you believe in the numbers, that mid-range shot is not a high-value shot, even with little or no defense on you.
They're making smart adjustments, setting guys up for success.
The possession's just way more efficient, I think, here tonight, taking smarter, better shots, moving the ball around. That's helped them to get back in the ballgame. If he's going to keep shooting, they've got to run some plays for him. Screens, pick and rolls, anything they can do to get him started.
For 3, Barrett. Gets the 3 to fall. Barrett's got 20.
A really good focus from RJ there. I think that improves his percentages.
Knicks lead, 69.
Smart passes to Brown. Jacks up a 3. And that's basket number 9 for him. He's 9 for 10.
What a performance. Hit 2 from beyond the arc in the first half, and he's added 3 more since.
The 3, Barrett. And again, New York with the triple.
Oh, you gotta love the back and forth, showing real confidence at the arc.
Yeah, both teams finding ways to the 3-point line and trying to take advantage from distance.
He was gripping the rock on the way to the slam.
No way he was going to get stripped on that one. The shot is good by Barrett.
All five of the last buckets they've given up have been from downtown.
Next lane.
Tatum inside. Check by Randall. Tatum, shot is good. Tatum's got 8 points in the quarter.
Not sure which clips they watched at halftime, but he has figured out how to attack the D, and they kept him in check in the first half. He's flipped it.
The three, Barrett. And so it's the New York Knicks, now holding a 12-point lead at quarter's end. And it's their three-point accuracy that has helped them build such a healthy lead. Time for a quick break, then back to the action. And it's time to bring up the State Farm assist to the game.
And the winner today coming from an unlikely position. It's the big fellow with the sweetest pass of the day.
You know, anytime a guy's in the post and the teammates know he's unselfish, great player movement can create an opportunity just like that.
And as we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works or if it's more of the same for the first three quarters. On the court right now for the Celtics, they've got Daniel Tice, Derek White out there with Peyton Pritchard. Then it's Nesmith, and it's Williams in at the four. For three, Barrett connects from downtown. Barrett's got 29 points.
Man, they're having a hard time defending the triple. That's three in a row.
And that's a foul called on Evan Fournier. That's his first foul.
New York foul. Evan Fournier. That's his first personal. First team foul.
And so it's Boston with it to the middle. Here's Tice. And finished off by Tice.
Hey, kept it simple. No reason to get fancy right now, B.A.
Yeah, he's just looking to find shots and produce for his team.
But we've been watching him hold court out of the arc. Just an unforgettable performance tonight.
Knicks lead, 81. 67.
Here's White. No, stopping him there. Jams it in. And he's fouled. Opportunity in a three-point play. It's going to go on Mitchell Robinson. Brown, he's checked in for Nesmith. And you talk to anyone about White, Grant, they'll tell you he's best when he's being assertive.
I totally agree. I mean, White can be caught standing around when he's not involved. You want him initiating and pick and roll, and he makes pretty good decisions. Now, he may never be a star, but he's going to give you solid minutes.
White, no good. New York goes the other way with it. And after this game wraps up, they're off to Orlando, where they'll face the Magic. It's a quick turnaround on the road. Just one game.
Defense shaking their heads. No idea how to stop him in this quarter. He's got him on the ropes.
87. 70.
Outside, Williams. And Williams punches it home.
And just a lack of fight right now on the defensive end.
Right? At least on that slam it was. That's one way to let a team back in the game. And again for three.
The parade of threes has no end in sight. He just keeps knocking them down.
And that latest triple ties him for second for most threes in a game. What a monster performance from deep it's been. And it's Tice missing. The Knicks have gotten off to a perfect 5-for-5 so far in the fourth. For three, Barrett. Connects again from distance.
And of course it falls for him. And that three pushing him into the record books.
He is now tied for the most threes in a game. An incredible shooting night for him on a night we'll never forget. And that's a foul called on Evan Fournier. That's foul number two for him.
13 foul.
Here's Pritchard. Outside, Williams drives to the hoop, uses the glass on the layup. Williams has got 4 points now in the quarter.
That's the kind of passing you want there. Work the ball around, keep it moving, try to get an assist on every bucket.
For three, Barrett. Good! Another from three.
Unbelievable. Gets the record with a beautiful three.
A new single-game record and a night that everyone will remember the rest of their lives.
Celtics ball timeout. R.J. Barrett. All right, look who's coming onto the court. Come on again, pal, for your next city dancer.
us in our New Balance Player of the Game, R.J. Barrett.
Think about this. He has owned this game from start to finish. Wow, so impressive. The defense literally looked helpless trying to stop him out there. He has been far and away the best player on the court, and it's not close.
Wow, he really played phenomenal tonight. But we've almost come to expect that from him. He feeds off the energy from this crowd, and it certainly plays a part in elevating his game. The three. Boston with a rebound. Williams has got rebound number 8 now. And there's a minute 45 left in the fourth quarter of this one. He was all alone on that one.
There's no lack of confidence in Tatum when it comes to his three-point shot. He's looking to do damage from long range on every possession.
Here's Barrett. Book it. And it's Randle with the assist. Randle's got his third assist of the night.
Absolutely ruthless. He's not about to start showing mercy now.
Confidence is sensational, and it feels like no one is going to stop him tonight from scoring.
It looks like it'll be a big win for them here. Time to just cruise to the end of the game and chalk up the victory for the Knicks.
They look to run any time they could.
They set the tone with their pace. Their transition game was excellent.
And so this win marks their first victory of the new year.
And against a familiar opponent, it's nice to establish a psychological advantage with a win in the first game.
And what a huge performance it was for R.J. Barrett.
Just does a great job of looking for space and then finding it. That's taking advantage of what the defense is giving you.
Here's Barrett. The rebound, Celtics.
You won't see him miss that one too many times.
Yeah, that happens. Important thing is for players, just don't beat yourself up and make a miss like that cost you another play.
And there it is for him.
And where was this type of effort earlier in the game? Unfortunately, this run will be all for nothing.
Consistency definitely is a key to some of the playoff performing teams, and tonight they just did not find it in this contest.
A nice shot by Tatum.
Nice play. Tatum consistent with that jump shot, especially off the catch.
It's Barrett on the wing. 6 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Tried to answer back, but that three is off the mark. Tatum against Burks. Baseline try. Tatum gets the bucket.
Growing into his role as a franchise player, Tatum with a huge game. It's been so much fun watching him tonight.
Barrett up top. Shoots over Tatum. And so New York takes this one by a big margin. Even early on in this game, they appeared happy to be playing at home.
And it makes a huge difference. Once they started to get into a groove, you never really felt like they wouldn't come out on top.
And that'll do it for this inaugural game of the NBA season. For Brent Berry, Grant Hill, and Ali LaForce, this is Brian Anderson. Thank you for watching this 2K Sports presentation of the NBA. And we'll see you next time.